This video was brought to you by Dollar Shave Club. Get top quality razors delivered to your door starting at just $1 a month. Link below in the description. Skip it up and that up. Well, as we all know, Destiny has been released, and now reviews are coming in, and it's not scoring as well, I'm sure, as Bungie would have hoped. It's not doing horrible. It's not like it's getting 40s and 30s and 2 out of 5s and all that, but on Metacritic right now, it's sitting at a 76, which for a game as hyped as Destiny was, I'm sure that Bungie and Activision are pretty disappointed by the review scores. And on top of it, to add insult to injury, Bungie may have lost out on a shit ton of cash due to the low review scores. Well, a shit ton of cash for you and I, for a major corporation like Activision, $2.5 million is a flash in the pan. But anyway, Bungie may have lost out on $2.5 million because the game didn't meet the review scores that Activision may have wanted. Let me explain. Back in 2012, when Activision was in court with Call of Duty creators Vince Zampella and Jason West, part of that court case, Activision had to share details of its original contract with Bungie for Destiny, which at the time was scheduled for release in 2013. This is what part of that contract said. Activision shall pay to licensor a quality bonus in the amount of $2,500,000 should Destiny, game number one, achieve a rating of at least 90 as determined by GameRankings.com or equivalent reputable services if GamerRankings.com is no longer in service, as of 30 days following the commercial release of Destiny game on the Xbox 360. Now, that contract is ancient. It's from 2010. It's been reworked since then, and maybe Bungie fought to get that clause removed so they could just get the money up front. Who knows? But it's old, and things could have changed. So I just want to put that out there that this isn't set in stone in this contract. So it's not guaranteed that Bungie lost $2.5 million because Destiny didn't get a 90 or above. The reason I really wanted to talk about this is not because of $2.5 million, because whatever. Like I said, to Bungie and to Activision, that's not that much money. To us, it's a shit ton of cash, but to a corporation or a huge developer like Bungie, it's not that much. But this is a prime example of when Destiny, I should say, is a prime example of when hype actually hurts a game. This game has been hyped for, let's say, a couple years now, and everybody thought that it was going to be the messiah of 8th gen. It was going to be what ushered in true next gen gaming. It's what was going to, everything before it was going to seem totally dated, and gaming from the release of Destiny was going to change. It was going to revolutionize everything. People really thought that because of how hyped this game was. And now that it's released, and people realize, oh, it's just a really good first-person shooter with MMORPG elements, they're like, oh, I'm disappointed. It isn't going to cure cancer and give me a bigger penis. Damn. All right, I'm going to give it a 70 as opposed to a 90 because it isn't revolutionary. That's what I think is really happening. I still admittedly have yet to play the game. I have not had a damn chance to sit down and play it, but I really want to. And I want to see what all the hype or all the disappointment's really about. But I kind of feel bad for Bungie in a way. I mean, not too bad. They made back all of their money that they put into Destiny in a day. But I think this was really like they wanted to step out of the Halo realm and be like, hey, we could do more than Halo. And even like Michael Pachter said, he's like, you know, yeah, okay, it made a lot of money, but they need to bring up those review scores to make it a valid franchise. And he's right, they do. Because if the game continues, like say they come out with a sequel to Destiny and it disappoints too, there may be no more Destiny after that. So, you know, it kind of sucks. I just think the game was too hyped and it's falling victim to that. And I do, like I said, feel bad for Bungie because I'm sure they put their heart and soul into this game. All right, folks, this is Rich of Review Tech USA. Make sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe. And as always, thank you for supporting my channel. Have a good one. The preceding video was brought to you by Big Cheese's YouTube channel. For gameplay reviews, gaming music, and vlogs, subscribe to Big Cheese VG. Link below in the description.